Hello my friends and welcome back for episode 27 of our Ered Luin campaign in Third Age, Total War, Divide and Conquer. So, we are still of course at war with Isengard and will be for probably quite a while. We did take Dunyart and Karas last time and we are pushing onwards. Reinforcements are streaming in and we are inching closer towards Isengard, the settlement itself. So I don't think I still need to do anything this turn. Although I guess I could muster up these forces already. Durin's over here. Beautiful. Right on cue, my friend. Right on cue. Alright, let's start by giving this man a catapult, because catapults are king. And then let's go with the pikes. The phalanx. Any phalanx in here? No, but regular pike. And regular pike here as well. Beautiful. Also phalanx here. Beautiful like that. That's a ton of pikes. Alright, let's now get some crossbows in there. Actually, let's see. Do you have any elite crossbows? No. We actually don't have that many crossbows in this army. Oops, did I do it wrong? No, okay. Well, we get four crossbow units in total, which... Actually, five. That's not too bad. That's actually quite good. And let's get some Sons of the Fallen in there. They will do excellent against the Wargs. Some Gabilgathul Guard. And one more Obsidian or Grimborn Reaver. Alright. We still have some reserves in here. Which we will save for a rainy day. Alright. So these guys can go back home for retraining. I did make a bit of a mistake sending these guys out there. We probably should have pushed this army out. But I do hope they attack me at the bridge here. We could have a very fun time. And I also want to move the troops out of Harad at one point. It's just, there's so much cleaning up to do. Anyway, I'll actually stand a bit closer as to not lure out the Orcford force. Yeah, Isengard's bloody annoying. But I mean, we are pushing forward and we are getting, I think I forgot to move the fleet. Oh, I'm an idiot. Oh, whatever. Oh, okay. They moved a little bit on their own, but... They refuse to merge. They probably get attacked by those pirates. Cursed pirates! I'm gonna go full Julius Caesar on your ass. I wish you could, like, stop the pirates somehow. They have, like, a pirate cove somewhere, and if you track it down, you can kill them all, you know. That'd be fun. But sadly, that's not the case. Now, we are inching closer towards the end of this campaign. In fact, if I wanted to finish it, I could finish it rather quickly. Because we do, of course, have... You know what? Actually, try to fight that. Ah, he's got ballista. Let's run. I don't think he can catch. Okay, never mind. I don't care too much about this. It's a shame, and it's a bit silly of me to throw them away, but whatever. Yeah, it's a bit. Oh, I could have actually accepted that. I'm so used to pressing like the exterminate populace or whatever, the kill hostages. My mouse just automatically veered off to the right. Alright, yeah, they're trying to chase me. Why can this guy move so much further? Oh, probably because he has troops. So you know what? I think I'll just put them on land. I don't think it's worth it to risk losing them. But like I said, you know, this campaign's coming to an end, and I'm very much looking forward to the next campaign, which I might just start recording later today, depending on how time goes. Let's quickly take care of Captain Naguk. You know, I could auto-resolve some battles, but Isengard is the auto-resolve king. They got, like even in these odds where we will kill them with probably zero losses or next to zero losses, they still have a 6-to-1 ratio. That's like... That's not that bad, 6-to-1. I mean, it's bad, but this should be a bajillion to none, in all honesty. Yeah, I'm very much looking forward to starting the next campaign, and as I have... talked about in previous videos, I'm gonna try and give it a bit of a different spin. So we're gonna do more editing, you know, I'm gonna cut out the loading times. The videos will be shorter because of that, but it will be the same length of recording. So I'll record for like an hour to an hour and a half, which is what I do now as well. But because I cut out some shit, they will be, of course, a bit of a slope there, a bit shorter. That makes sense. No, actually, I'm gonna move back a little bit. I forgot actually about a ton of... Actually, this is a pretty beefy army, oh my god. okay. But yeah, if you guys like that, then I would kindly ask for you to give the video, the first episode at least, a like. Because that, of course, gives me a better view. Ah, Sons of the Fallen. I think that's the first time we're using them in battle. Look at them. Oh, they're really cool. I think you can only train them in territories that were once controlled by Orcs or Angmar, like mountain regions that didn't belong to you, but they belong to your ancestors at one point or something like that. I think that's the lore aspect of it. Yeah, I mean, I'm not the best at editing videos and doing crazy fun stuff, so I'm not gonna make it too crazy. But I'll edit out the loading times, I'll insert, like, specific slides for every battle. Let's do it, fire. But I would very much appreciate every support, and you guys have been giving me crazy support, especially lately. It's been insane, so if you guys could keep that up, that would make my day. Seriously, it would. Alright, the Uruk-hai infantry. I mean, you cannot get tired of looking at them. They look so cool. Oh, that's a big one. That was such a good shot that, like, changed their mind a bit. Like, are you sure you want to go through with this? Ooh, okay. I guess I can already tell you what the next faction will be. Or maybe I should keep it a bit of a secret. Nah. So, for those of you who watched the Khan campaign, we'll probably know that in the last video of the Khan campaign, the finale, I did a little bit of a poll. Just a regular poll, nothing too crazy, just be like, you know, put the faction you want me to play next in a comment. It can be any faction, it can be good faction, evil faction, it can be a faction we've played before, we haven't played before, it can be literally anything. And the winner was, I didn't even have to count the votes because it was so obvious, because it got an overwhelming amount of responses, was Dale. So the next campaign we will be playing will be Dale. We don't do anything crazy, we're just going to do a regular Dale campaign. I've never played Dale before, so it will be fun. Very new, I'm very much looking forward to it, because Dale's... From what I've seen, you know, I looked at the faction overview by Ered Luin, and... Well, that's pretty much it. It seems like they suffer economically at the beginning, but they have the potential to become a real powerhouse. They're one of those factions that you could potentially use for a world conquest or world domination or painting the map, whatever you want to call it. This Uruk-hai just running in, going in melee. If I knew that was the case, I would have pulled back the crossbows. Let's actually pull back the crossbows. I know I usually be like, stick to your guns, but I don't want to lose any unnecessary amount of troops. I love how they're completely disobeying my commands. They're like, nope, we're not moving. Come on, lads. Oh, I take no responsibility for that. The crossbows have such a slow reaction time. It's something with their animations. Yeah, they just lost a ton of troops in that charge because they're bloody morons. Oh, well. I mean, I can't do much else but try. You know what? Maybe I should actually give the Ereklund scouts, like, the withdraw command. I think they might move faster than... Yeah, that would actually be better if I had to pull them back in a pinch. Like we saw over here. Stop firing. Actually, you can fire on crossbows. You don't have to fire. You'll just kill friendlies. Go kill him. It's done. It's over. My god, we're losing more phalanx than I would like as well. There we go. Dead on. 75, that's not enough. Let's see if we can get some more kills. There we go. We poked him. Should be able to get some more kills with crossbows and with the catapult. Right? 79 ain't enough to make them rout entirely. Ah, whatever. They're done. Get out of here. Get out of here. Yeah, I'm sure if I auto-resolved that, it would have been a much worse result. Which, you know, that's not entirely accurate. I also uploaded the Khant vs. Isengard video today. I hope you guys enjoyed that one. It was really fun to make, actually. I kind of forgot how fun it was to play Khant, because they have so much cavalry. It's so different compared to the dwarves. And don't get me wrong, I love playing as the dwarves. But I miss my cavalry, you know. Which, that's one thing about Dale that I will appreciate, is they have a very... How do I put that? A very robust roster. They have good cavalry, they have good infantry, they have good archers. Nothing amazing, just all good. Alright, so we almost take down the rank. This is good. Something I kind of lost track of. Oh, no, no. You need to go to Bree for retraining. Alright, so our economy is looking a bit more stable. Now we can actually build some stuff. Send them to siege. What settlement? Armed grain. Oh, that's actually good. I want them to attack. Alright, yeah, he's coming after Karas, which is annoying because I really wanted to send out Grinfahan. Alright, well, let's take care of Goslin first. That's another very ugly general we can take care of quickly. What's that thing with nails? Rusty steel nails. Why would you bring that along? Alright, so let's quickly kill him. It's another great commander gone. I mean, they really can't have that many more generals lying around. Well, good generals at the very least. We've killed plenty. We haven't killed any noteworthy generals though, like Lurtz or Saruman or... Who else is there? I haven't killed any of them. Oh, some older lords. This army is not looking so healthy. They do have two catapults, though. And three Grimborn Reavers and some cavalry, so... Alright, just go nuts. We can kill him without losing anyone, I think. Ooh, what the hell are you aiming at? Alright, he's gonna be a little bitch. That's okay. Not you. Alright, let's rush forward and kill that ugly motherfucker. You are one ugly motherfucker. If you get that reference, you're pretty awesome. He looks prettier on the battlefield than he does on his picture. That's a weird thing to say about a Uruk-hai, isn't it? He looks prettier in real life. Alright, let's move on in, lads. Ah, boys. I hope you're all doing well. I'm doing very well because I'll be eating quesadillas later today. So that just puts a smile on my face now, doesn't it? It's one of those foods that I wake up in the morning, I'm like, oh yes, I'm eating that today, and I'm so looking forward to it. I don't have that with a lot of food, but quesadillas is one of them. I got to say, with this entire corona lockdown, and making food at home, because I usually eat food at our company restaurant, of course. But I'm not going to hate on the company restaurant, the food's decent, but the food at home is so much better. I'm not that much of a cook, but I take joy in it, you know? I really enjoy making food and eating my own food. It just tastes better if you've put some effort into it, you know? Kind of like winning a Total War game, or a Total War campaign. The harder the hill to climb, you know, the prettier the view. The more you can savor it and enjoy it. Can my catapult start fighting yet? No. This hill is not doing me any favors, eh? Let's push a little bit closer. Let's keep the cavalry in standby in case that guy starts running, but I doubt he will. Oh, come on, we're still not in range. Come on, lads. Not even the Brobby marksman. Now we're in range. Beautiful. Let's start peppering that ugly motherfucker. Look at him, look at him. Yeah, man, maybe you should do something. Actually, I don't think I killed anyone. They make the smacking sound, so I guess someone's bones are broken. Nice. Now we hit him. Oof. Couple hits in quick succession. Let's switch to grape shot. And watch the damage unfold. Oh my god. Yeah, that changes the mind a little bit. They're like, oh, are you sure you want to go through with this? Alright, the grape shot's overshooting me a little bit, but it's still sniping them. Come on, I don't want to pull back my troops. Crossbows, keep firing! 21... 11... My god, does it drop fast. They're pretty impervious to the crossbow fire. Oh, there it goes. Boom! Oh! How many got left? Probably no, just like the one. I think we got some friendly fire. Ah, we got some friendly fire because of the catapult. Hmm, that's odd. End battle. I thought with the firing arc it would fire over it, but I guess it must have been pretty close because we dwarves are quite short. Don't stand high above the ground. Ah, well, doesn't matter. That's not gonna make the difference in the grand scheme of things. Although, you know, all those small losses, if you add them up, that's a ton of people we've killed ourselves. Ah, well. Ah, well. It's all about achieving victory at all costs. Alright, Captain Gorlon. You're gonna go after Karas because you're an annoying little bugger. I think I'll go round, actually. You're not gonna take Karas in one go. I mean, Bregnus is looking pretty open, but I just do not have the forces. Yeah, you're done. Alright, Glain. Well, I mean, these guys are gonna keep being annoying. I should send this force out. They're so good with their three catapults. They can do so much damage. Alright, let's start fighting. But yeah, I mean... This is what I mean, look at this spam! Just look at it! We cleaned up last episode and now they're all back. They just keep pumping out units. And I do want to push and take settlements because I know that's the key to stopping this, but... I need to do something about all this. I can't just let them just walk around. Because that makes it difficult to control the settlements that I've taken. He'll just retake them and start producing more units because his culture is still there. So yeah, this is it's annoying. It's annoying. I don't think he had wargs. I don't really check his armies, but they were rather small. I doubt he has wargs. And we have three catapults! I mean, what's not to like about having three bloody catapults going nuts? Alright, let's get our three catapults. I will mention that as often as I can, that we have three bloody catapults. Then let's get our infantry on the flank. Actually, I have a ton of infantry. I shall lead you. It's got a ballista and a bit of a hill, so that's rather annoying. What's he bringing in here? Okay. No wargs. Alright, don't have to worry too much about the flanks. Alright, let's just move everyone then. He's getting his ballista in range, which is rather unfortunate. Although he is a bit stupid, so he's not really moving them. He's just moving back and forth. Let's see if our catapult can snipe some of them. Right, they're rushing forward. Are those berserkers? They are. Okay, let's fire on them. Let's kill those berserkers. Because they scare the living piss out of me. Any other scary units? No, not really. Just break those. More berserkers. Oh, God. Man loves his berserkers. I mean, I can't blame him. Besides the Nazg-Hai, it's the best unit he can throw at me. And luckily, the AI cannot get Nazg-Hai, I'm pretty sure. I mean, I say luckily, it's kind of sad. It would be cool to see some Nazg-Hai. But I think I might just hit the ballista by trying to shoot the berserkers. Funny how that goes. Alright, these guys don't stand a chance. Alright, let's see. I think we might get a lucky shot. Yeah, hit one guy. If he's gonna fire like that, he's surely gonna hit his own berserkers. Oh, beautiful. That was a direct hit. Fuck the berserkers, man. As long as I don't have to face him in actual combat, I'll be a happy man. Like I said, man, they scared that piss out of me. Keep firing, lads. Oh, you're way undershooting. Oh, God. I don't like that, but not much I can do about that. Alright, let's go nuts with the grape shot. Fire that grape shot! I need it! I need it now! Come on! Come on, fire! Yeah, there we go. Fuck him up. Yeah, doing some numbers here. We're actually killing most of these berserkers because of the backsplash. Alright, so we've already decimated that unit. Beautiful. Let's keep it up, you know. The less we have to face them in combat, the better. Because they annihilate everything we can throw at them. I mean, I guess I have a bit of a hard time getting through our pikes most of the time, but... Look at them grunting. My god. They're armored again, so... They're probably straight from Isengard itself. Can I check? They have an infantry unit. It should display the legion they're in. I thought they had an infantry unit. Guess not. Alright, beautiful. But I think that's half of one army. Oh no, it's half in total. Nice. Alright, berserkers are gone. Now we can fire on those other laddies there. Crossbows and archers. He's got some berserkers back here as well, but... I'll probably kill a couple of them just by hitting them. Yep, there we go. Nice. Captain down. Only half the enemy force remains. Captain down. Gap of Rohan is where they're from. Alright, just keep firing. Yeah, that berserk unit got decimated just by backsplash. Huh. Beautiful, man. Grapeshot just kills everyone. They don't care. It has such a wide range. Send out an army to take care of that ballista. Just shoot up all the others, it doesn't matter too much. Nice. Another one abides the grapestone. A grape shot. Why do I call it a grapestone? Grapestone is like at the core of a grape. This is grape shot. Alright, if you're firing that, might as well fire on that, eh? However, if you want to keep doing the grape shot. Whatever. You know what? Don't fire on the ballista because my infantry has arrived. Those five berserkers won't do much either. Alright. Get out of here. Let's end it. 52. Yeah, man, but we're just doing cleanup every bloody 5 seconds. It's so hard to progress. Ugh. Banner spam is real, man. It's bloody real. And there's not much I can do about it. I can counter it with my own banner spam, and slowly but surely we are making progress. But unless something happens on, like, the other flanks, the other front lines, then... I don't know, man. What? Why do you run that way? We even have this. This is like our zone of control. How do you? What? Whatever. I'm not even gonna judge, man. Alright, enough folly. You're actually really fucking useful. Because of your 3 catapults. That is so strong. Let's go take down this guy. He's the big mean daddy of them all. And. He's annoying, but we have 3 catapults. So, what's he gonna do? I hope this guy goes for Harad, the guy on the left side. Because we can easily win him in a, or kill him in a siege fight there. But I don't think this will ever end unless we control Isengard and put an army on the bridge to the Gap of Rohan. Okay, so this is a very nice hill. This is a rather nice hill. And get our pikemen. Now they do have some wargs, so I might be so actually, no. We'll not put pikes on the flank, we'll just use our regular infantry. They're more than capable of taking down wargs. And we have plenty of them. You'll be safe in my company. Make sure to have a really strong flank there. We'll keep the Grimborn Reavers in the middle, because sometimes you notice that they get through our pike line, despite this being a rather thick one. So they'll be in reserve to assist whatever necessary. Probably if like Berserkers show up or anything like that. Alright, so make sure they're all on guard mode. And then Catapult can just go nuts the moment the battle starts. Alright. So, just fire away. Every hit's good. Let's do one regular volley and then switch to grape shot right away. Maybe even switch sooner because they are getting... I'll just do one regular shot. They're already loaded. Fire it away. Alright, and I switch to grape shot. Ooh, nice. That's probably their captain. Yep, there's their captain. I doubt he'll be granted a long life. He's got some berserkers. I think just the one unit, it seems. Yes. Well, maybe the extra army's berserkers as well. Yup. There's always more of them, eh? Never ends. Alright. Grape shot. You're going to do so much damage. That should be an awesome firing angle. So we're at 7% now. Let's see what happens after that volley of grape shot. 10%. Alright, so we are actually going to do our new strategy of withdrawing them. Hopefully that makes them move quicker. Nope! What the hell? The hell is that? What the hell is that? Someone's raining fire on me. Is that the ballista crew? Look at this. It's like firebombs. What? Who's doing that? Do they have not... Goodness gracious, they have Nazg-Hai. How do they have Nazg-Hai? I didn't know they could get Nazg-Hai. I thought the AI could not get Nazg-Hai. What the hell is going on? They have Nazg-Hai. They have Nazg-Hai. How do they have Nazg-Hai? I'm confused. I'm visibly, or audibly, I should say, confused. Where did they get Nazg-Hai from? Oh no. Oh no, that complicates things, my friends. Nazg-Hai are proper scary, man. They're fucking scariest unit in the game. Oh no. Oh no, 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 no. How did I miss that? How did I miss that? Oh god. So this went from a pretty easy battle to fucking Nazg-Hai. They've got Nazg-Hai. We need to act fast. Kill those wargs, they just didn't stand much of a chance. You can't fire, you pull back. It's as simple as that. Fire on the captain, kill the captain. And those Nazg-Hai are not gonna run. They're Nazg-Hai, they don't give a fuck. Alright, so my worst nightmare is coming true, holy fuck. I mean, it's cool to see them in action, don't get me wrong, I fucking love the Nazg-Hai, but... rather not face them, rather have them on my team instead of facing them, you know? Alright. Let's do a flanking maneuver there, that is. They are still just led by a captain. Despite the Nazg-Hai probably never running, we can rout the rest. Goodness gracious, I pooped my pants a little bit. I'll have to clean myself up after this recording. Ah, oh, but holy fuck, I did not see that coming. I thought they couldn't train them. Oh no, they destroyed the catapult I'm not using! The terror of it all. Where are the Nazg-Hai? I don't actually see them. He's got berserkers there. Yeah, I'm not really sure. Alright. Well, at least we're doing some flanking here. Closing our ranks. Our pikes are holding out nicely. Grimborn Reavers are doing damage. Scaring the enemy as well. We do need to keep an eye on that flying though. So I will actually move them. Berserkers. Oh. Kill that general, please. Another ballista firing shots from that angle. Ooh. My god. What a battle. What a bloody battle. Holy fuck. Not a catapult down. Alright, well, this regular old infantry is dying rather quickly. Spear Guard and Bane Guard, they are running away and they are dying. But that is, of course, not all we have to take care of. Yeah, but we've lost 13%. That's actually not too bad. Alright, that Bane Guard came back, annoyingly. Where the hell is that captain? Oh, he's over there. Bloody oaf. Come on, kill him! Boom. Alright, move around. Get on the flank. Go on. Get, yep, there we go. Just keep firing, I guess. Doesn't matter too much. Alright. We are winning now. Oh, that's Nazg-Hai. They're not doing a whole lot because they're stuck on my pikes, but... Oh no, one got in the rear. Oh god. Could probably go kill him. Oh, nice. Good snipe, good snipe. That's gonna help out. I'm sure most of you are curious to see the Nazg-Hai. They have 2 hit points, 26 total defense, so that makes them proper beasts. So Saruman has the ring, what the hell? Melee attack of 15, missile attack of 12. Yup. And a charge bonus of 12. That's about, like, that's one knight level. They inspire nearby troops. They probably frighten nearby enemy. Yup. They're armor piercing with 15 attack. And they are skilled against mounts as well. They're just amazing. They're amazing. It's literally nothing bad to say about them. They do everything you want them to do and they do it well. Alright, we are closing the gaps. And it is looking rather good for us. A lot of them are running, just wish I had some cavalry to, of course, run them down, trample them. But that's sadly not in the cards. Alright, some more mass routes. Which should leave the Nazg-Hai surrounded, so we can slaughter them. I mean, slaughter. We can kill them. There's no slaughtering Nazg-Hai. There just isn't. You can kill them, you can do some damage to them, but they will always kill many more of you than you kill of them. Okay. So it's our elites versus their elites. Oh, and they just got a firebomb to their face from point blank. Jesus. Let's pull back our Tumunzar nobles. It's a little bit risky. Alright. They still have 62% remaining, which is a lot. I would want to kill some more of them. Yeah, just I don't have cavalry. That's such a nuisance to not have cavalry. Because we are so slow. Some more berserkers. I think it's Nazg-Hai Ard. Still got a couple remaining. Alright, 28%. We should heal a couple though. Bloody Nazg-Hai. Strong lads. Alright. Move in. Catapult. I mean, if you want to, you can try firing on the ballista. Might get something done. Might not. Such is the mystery of life. Alright, they're fucked. Oh, what are you shooting at? It's annoying.
Only half the enemy force remains.
Half? Oh, half from the reinforcements, I imagine. Yeah, 76. That ain't half, buddy. At least he's taking care of those runners.
The enemy general
nice.
Lies dead.
Beautiful. Let the crows have his miserable bones. Yeah, keep firing. Well, that's not the last we'll see of those guys, but at least the Nazg-Hai are done. Goodness gracious, man. I did not expect to face a Nazg-Hai squadron. Oh no. Oh, he's coming back and slaughtering my longbeards. Come on, Grimborn. Let's get in there. Alright. That was a fucking rubbish charge. Oh my god, they slaughtered my longbeards and then they started running? Assholes. Wait, who's attacking you? Oh god, this berserk. Ah! He's all over the place, man, and it's. Crossbows. Kill them. Yeah, he keeps running in the fucking trees and then coming back. What the hell's your deal, man? Probably exploiting his charge bonus a bit. No charge for you. No.
The battle is very much in our favor.
If we oh my god. That was... I mean, 38% isn't too bad considering how many we slain, but... Whew. What a rough fight, man. Alright, can we finish this bloody berserkers? Just double pike him. Oh my god. So that's 27%, so a quarter. And their armies are gone. Our catapults didn't do as much as I would have liked, but yeah, they did rush forward quite hard. And those Nazg-Hai, man. I wonder if the Nazg-Hai firebombs can actually destroy siege equipment. I'm not so sure about that. Alright. Goodness gracious, that was... Whew, that was something else. Oh, but that doesn't bode well, you know. If we're gonna face many more Nazg-Hai, I will cry. Why are they all running north? At least they're stuck. Just put him on the bridge there. I should take care of Lughorn, because then the Harad force could move out. But like, every battle we win. Just sets up more and more. If I end the turn now, because I've done all my battling, he'll just double his numbers up here. It's... Alright, Mr. Glean. You know what? Screw Harad, they can defend themselves. Also, there were two armies in this area. Where did that one army move to? That's annoying. I don't know where they are. Oh, there they are. So you might go after Grin Farm. Captain Mog. That's not ideal. I think I should take him on myself. Oh my god. Do you need any more ballistae, lad? Ah, that is such an annoying army. Four ballistae? But I can't let him go attack Grin Farm. Oh, lads. If I can be completely honest with you, I don't think we'll continue this campaign until we've defeated all of Isengard. That will simply take too long, because they just spam. And most of Rohan's land and Gondor land will already be fully corrupted to Saruman's corruption. So taking those territories will be just as tough as these are. They will no doubt be have become part of their heartland. And then the game blesses me with a fucking forest battle. Ugh. Alright. Thing is, we need to be rather aggressive because we need to shut down this bloody ballistae. I guess my personal goal is to take the Isengard settlement. We can continue from there, because I think this is also not that much fun for you guys either to watch, because we're doing the same thing every episode. We're fighting the same armies in the same locations. It's just the same battles over and over again. And that's something that I don't like about Divide and Conquer. It's spam. Spam. There's so much spam. Alright, anyway, let us fire away. Is that Nazg-Hai? Okay, it's Berserkers. It actually hit one of the fucking catapults. Ballistae, nice. I know they have some trolls in here, right? No? That was another army. Okay, this army doesn't have trolls. Good. So what are you doing? You're pushing forward? We do have the hill advantage, which is quite nice. Even if my catapult's not in the best location for it, I should have moved it more here. That's okay. And he's firing away. We already killed 5% though, so... it's okay. Let him have his fun for now. Alright, let's see if we can already switch to Grave Shot. I think we can. Yep. Go nuts, laddies! Go nuts! Let's already move them. Because we do have a ton of troops. Let's move back our crossbows already, I think. I just can't see shit, so it's very hard to play. So I don't want to risk my crossbows, because they are crucial. Can't have pike and shot without shot, right? Alright, so that's dragging the attention of the Baneguard, which is not too bad. If he wants to take me on, let him. Let him have it. I'm not sure what you're firing at. I hope some berserkers. But don't move. Just fire whatever you want. I don't really care. Alright, so he's moving back. He's like, no, we're not gonna attack. So he's going full on my flanks now. Sorta. Not full on. Rather aggressively, anyway. This captain's all the way over here. Let's see if we can kill him rather quickly. Alright, so how's it looking? These guys don't stand much of a chance. That's just an outlier. Alright. Oi, oi, oi. Alright, whatever. Let's fight on the berserkers, please. He's going nuts on my broad beams, which is kind of risky with my general behind them. One unlucky shot is all it takes. All in all, it's not looking too bad. Our pipeline should be able to hold. If only I had some cavalry. It would make my life so much easier. Alright, speed up a little bit. There's not much maneuvering to be done right now. They got berserkers on the flanks, which is not ideal. Let's see if we can move our scouts around a little bit. You guys make sure to fire on these guys. Take down their bloody crossbows. Let's get shield wall in there. Now, Grimmar Reavers are getting cut up by those berserkers. Nice! That's so good! That's gonna make a difference. Oh, yes. These guys will probably rout. Yes! Yes! They're all routing now. If only I could run them down. We're so close to getting some Rohan cavalry, some Rohan riders. But, I mean, we cannot push, because they keep spamming forces. Wish I could see something as well. I were killing them rather quickly, rather handsomely. That's half their forces already gone. With more to follow, of course, of course. I'm sure they'll be coming back as well. If we surround them with infantry, they of course have a harder time pulling out without prisoners being taken as well. What are we facing here? Spearguard, pikes. Pull back. Just get out of there. The moment I show up, they just start running. Ha! Huh. Cowards. ~58%. I mean, that's fairly good. I thought I had some scouts around here in a position to fire. Oh, they're there. Oh, that's not ideal. But it could be worse. Alright, it's very hard to keep track of what the hell is going on. But I think our core is freed up now. We're also starting to attack the crossbows. And then we can shut down the ballista and be done with this mess. Alright, let's speed things up a bit. We are losing troops because of those ballista, of course. But rather unavoidable. Because he keeps coming back and running and coming back and slows everything down. Yeah, the spikeman, for example, just came back. I want to push on the ballistas, man. You know what? Ignore those spikemen. Oh my god. He's going ham. Last ditch effort. Come on, stop them, shut them down, shut them all down. So we won, but 75% is still a lot. I think we can get a couple more kills with some random crossbow fire. 76. Every percent counts, you know. Whew, that was a rough fight. I mean, we won it pretty convincingly. I mean, that army's not gone, but... 19%. Yeah, that's fine. I mean, that should open up some room for expansion. I mean, we all know that eventually I would win the war against Isengard. But it could easily take another 100 turns, I'm afraid. I don't think that's an over-exaggeration. I think it really could. Ah, well. We will see, we will see. I'm still having fun with it, don't get me wrong. But it just feels like it's gonna go on and on. Endlessly. Execute. Get out of here. So if we can wipe out this guy, then the road to Durwath and Bregnas should be pretty open. We can hold long grain. We need to make sure Gurn doesn't get too close. Keep him there. Once we kick them out, we can send Gurn to take the grain force. Tyrion's coming down. This guy, I hope he besieges Herod, and we can just defend Herod and have a fun time with that. That would be great. And then we just move these armies, keep them moving. To wherever. Okay, so now Dunlarak will fall, so at least we make some progress there. I was actually kind of getting worried that we might not take a single settlement in this episode, which would be quite shocking. Actually, I should not have ended my turn just yet. I need to check on the frontline settlements, make sure they're building stuff there. Troops, if possible, but probably not yet. Alright, Isengard. You gonna do anything? You're just gonna let me take a settlement? Okay, you're selling out. Captain Muzlur. Mass power is smack dab in the middle, so I'm not sure why he didn't sally out before that. Alright, so is Ballista gonna be next to useless because of a sally out? Ah, we don't have catapults. Fuck. Should have brought back one catapult. Ah, whatever. We'll just have a standard battle. Nothing too crazy. And I also moved out the cavalry from this army. Well, it doesn't matter too much. We don't need to run them down anyway. Just need to win. That's all we need to do. And then we can give Gore a new army. We'll actually send him back to Tharbad. Or bring over forces from Tharbad at the fort there. And just give Gore a brand spanking new army. With maybe some veterans thrown in there. Right, let's actually pause just for a second. Okay, so make sure that no one's holding out the siege equipment, which will be next to useless. We could use it as a shield or something. And let's move the crossbows. Let's make sure you guys are not in pike formation. Move them. Actually, move them. Some are still in pike formation. God damn it. Alright, can you guys cooperate for a bit here? No. Why do I suck this much balls? Run. You flank. You other flank. Actually, I should probably split them up, but whatever, I don't care enough. Alright, everyone's got their movement orders. Please don't dilly-dally. There's plenty of targets to be taken down already. Alright, I just place all my faith in my crossbows to go ham. Which I think they've already started rather well. Yep. It's firing that big clusterfuck over there. Should move him back in time though, because there's actually a bit of a gap here, which not that smart. Alright. Most of his forces should be depleted. He's got his ballista, but if he fires it like that, it'll probably do more friendly fire. Pick your feet up. All thanks, sentries. General over there. Why are you not running? Did I not click on you? Ugh. Run! There's still time. You'll be fine if you start running now. Good. Let's take care of the Zuruk Reavers real quick. That opens up the Grimborn Reavers to just go ham on their infantry. Ah, battle at last. There we go. They're already running. Just pike line, hold, nothing too fancy. Bean Guard should run as well rather quickly. Should scare them into submission. Man, it's been a while since we used the special ability. Yeah, go fuck them up. They'll run, probably. They're scared of us. The enemy are badly blocked. They can't actually get through our pikes. Alright, let's keep killing. Keep slaying them. Mr. Gore himself. Killing the captain. Nice. Alright, can we get the others out of here now? That'd be rather nice. Shut down that fucking ballista. Maybe stop fighting for now. Alright. Nice. That ballista better not be firing still. Or I will be sad. Move you over. I can bring the pikes in closer as well. Might as well. They'll probably run straight up again. And at one point they'll all be running and then we will have one. It's as simple as that. Oh, we slaughtered them all. Like they have that much left. 13%. That ain't shit, man. Alright, just get in there, kill them all, infantry. It's time! A bit of a warm up for ya. Kill them. Alright, let's make sure we're in shield wall so we can shove them away. Get out of here! Oh, look at that. Whew, they're pushing hard. And I think that is our cue for having seized all of Dunland. I don't think there's any of the Dunland Heartlands not in our possession right now. Perhaps Bregnus counts as Dunland territory, but I'm not sure. We also have all of Enidwaith. We also have all of Bree, if I'm not mistaken. And all of Angmar. Except for Litash, I guess. We don't have Litash, I think. The one settlement closest to Mount Gundabad, I think that's in Ered Luin hands, right? Yeah, we have Khazad-Dûm, and that's the furthest we go. Mount Gram as well, we do not have. We have most of the Angmar territory. Alright. What the hell is this? What the hell is this? Just shoot him. What are you doing out there, archers? Trying to be sneaky? Where are you going? Annoying ass hat. Trying to make their way out of the city before it falls or something? I don't know what they're doing. They're dying. That's what they're doing. There we go. A clear victory. Alright, so we at least have taken one settlement this episode, so it's a resounding success. Alright. I would like to take one more settlement, though. If we get two settlements every episode, we would progress rather quickly. Dundurak has fallen. Let's exterminate the populace because I don't want to deal with that bullshit. Yeah, as expected. Yeah. It's good that I brought that guy. I should have let them team up. Yeah, well. Live and let die. Alright, so our money is getting rather nice. So what I will do... What I will do is move Durin to Dundurak. And then Mr. Gore can lead this army. It's an army befit of a king. Or a clan lord. We'll leave those troops in Dundurak just for a little bit. Let's make sure to... We don't need to repair anything, but we do need to get some culture. Then let's take a look. Fjord can be upgraded. Nice. Roads in Ostgallon. Right, let's just take a look at all the settlements at the border. Hello, game. Can you please cooperate? Why is it acting weird? Okay, there we go. Dunyard. Well, we just took it. No, wait, we took that before. That's Dunyard. I always mix up Dunyard and Dundurak. Let's get a pub. Just need culture, really. Can't get anything there. Yeah, please besiege that. So I don't have to send forces to take care of you. Ulk for the mining complex would be quite nice, but I'd rather have Feast Hall first. Suduri. Actually retrain these lads. Can't retrain the merchant cavalry yet, though, sadly. Karas, we are building. Okay. So already there's more forces coming in. It never ends, my friends, it never ends. But at least it's a bit clearer here. Oh, no! No! Where do you keep coming from? Get out of here! Oh, Isengard's right there. It's right there. I can already smell it. The pits of Isengard. The armpits of Isengard, more like it. Let's see if I can take care of Muznag. Triple catapult squad versus triple ballista squad. The showdown of the ages. Alright, let's fucking go. Boom. It's another general that we can take out. I mean, we are pushing closer and closer, right? We are making progress. Even though it doesn't feel like we're making progress. We are making progress. Alright, let's start deploying. What the hell is this? Okay, so... Not ideal terrain, but it will do. I don't pay too much attention to what units he has. I should do that more. And then let's get crossbows in front. Just the regular pike and shot lineup, you know. Nothing too crazy. Triple catapults just in the middle. Yeah, this army is a bit more depleted than the other one. Still should have more than enough men to destroy them utterly. Alright, let's make sure you're on defensive and the catapults as well, and you'll probably start fighting straight away. Yep, beautiful. Just go nuts. I have faith in your fire at will. They are getting ready to fire. Alright, that's one less ballista to worry about. Another one. Yeah, let's just tank it. How did that ballista not get destroyed by that? That looked like a direct hit. He's got a berserker's station there, so that's quite nice. It seems like they have different animations when they're armored. Because they hold their... Oh, no. Now they go in the regular RuneScape two-hander animation, it seems. Nice. Alright, so we're winning the skirmish. He doesn't have enough men to man the four ballista. I think they have more ammo than me, though. Okay, so we're resorting to grapeshot now. How much more ammo does a ballista have? Does it say it anywhere? I don't think it does. I don't think there's any... Would be useful if it said how much ammo it had, but okay. Guess it kind of depends. No, it shouldn't depend, really. Alright, so I think we just need to, hang on, move our entire army forward. No, forward. Oh crap, what am I doing? No, everyone... Oh, fuck. I didn't see them moving, rushing forward suddenly. Everyone just stop and get in your original position. I wish there was like a command for that. Just wherever you are, get back in your position. No, you should run. Catapults as well, just stay in your position. I should probably already move my... Oh fuck, I'm panicking. I'm blabbering on. Alright, doesn't help with these fucking trees, man. Whatever. We'll see what they do. I hope it works out. Okay, at least he's taking a little bit of a breather there. Fucking ballista, man. Like, I'm not sure what these guys are doing, for example, but whatever. As long as you stick in your position, then it's okay. Right on the general. Get a quick kill on him. Yeah, he has much more ammo than I do. Probably because I have two types of ammo. So he probably has double the ammo of one of mine. Does that make sense? He has both the ammo that I have for grape shot and for regular shot. I should be able to snipe that general rather easily. Come on. That was a horrible miss. Why are you firing here? He's over there. I'll even tank some friendly fire if I have to, just to kill the general. It's worth it, lad, it's worth it. Ooh, I don't like this battle. I don't like it. I feel like we're suffering too many casualties. Come on, fire on the bodyguard, you should be able to. Catapult, sometimes you don't cooperate. It seems like the triple ballista do outperform the triple catapults. Somewhat. Probably not in sheer numbers, but in gut feeling they do. It doesn't help that Isengard has a bajillion ballista in every army, though. Alright, he's moving his general. Fire. Nice! Beautiful! That's what I like to see. Alright, seems the ballista's finally stopped firing. And there they go, they're all running. Nice, just keep firing, keep killing. He's got cell swords. Oh, damn it. They have lost half their men. Our men are winning the battle. If we continue like this, we will smash the enemy. Alright, keep going, laddies. Oh no, they started firing again. They probably picked up that one ballista that still had ammo that they left behind before. Alright, let's take care of those berserkers. Right, 76% is not too horrible. Can we shut down that fucking ballista, please? It's giving me a heart attack. Alright, so we're under 20% loss. That's not too bad. I tend to overreact a bit. I always assume that we're losing horribly, but then if you look at the numbers, it's like, eh. No, don't you dare fire. I'm coming for you, man. Alright, let's just get rid of those berserkers, and that should be the end of that. Should be the last guy there. 82%, yeah. I think that's all we'll get. I don't think we'll be able to kill any more. I mean, we're firing at those guys, but that's not going to make the difference. So we lose 14%. That's not too bad. We kill another general. A little bit of friendly fire there. Catapult did really well, though. So, yeah. It seems the good old Freddy versus Jason, oops, I mean Catapult versus Ballista fight, did result in a win for the Catapult. But let's be honest, we all saw that one coming, eh? We all saw that one coming. Alright, execute. Oh look, there's already a new army taking its place. It never ends. It literally never ends. Oh, hello, Khazad-Dûm. You're joining in there, lad. Some First Legion, the strongest Dwarven unit in the game. At least in version 3. So let's just assume you'll attack Herod. Well, we have to take care of these armies then. Captain Golan. My god, it never ends. It never ends. It goes on and on and on. What are we facing here? One ballista, a couple pikes, a couple crossbows, just a regular old Isengard army. Can anyone do me a number crunch and tell me how many battles we've already fought against Isengard? I wish I could do that, yeah. Alright, start deployment! The Grindfarn squad, the very depleted Grindfarn squad, but... still strong enough to take care of those punks. More than strong enough to take care of these lads. So one of the few armies with cavalry. Alright, go nuts. Cavalry will take care of that ballista for us. Actually, before I say go nuts, let's make sure everyone's at the right... whatever you want to call that. Mode. Fighting stance. Alright, laddies. Let's take a look. That's a pretty good shot. Yeah. No complaints there. Not sure what that ballista's aiming at, but I embrace it. That's already 2% now. Yeah, I think he's trying to shoot my cavalry, which is perfect, because I can just... keep running around the rosy. Ring around the rosy. Oh, he's actually hitting with this archer. That's okay, they'll heal. They will heal. Because they are getting completely fucked. Maybe we should already switch to grape shot. Usually, when the broad beams get in range, it's not too far off for the grape shot. It's annoying that he keeps his crossbows there, because I'd like to run into the ballista, but then, of course, the crossbows will fuck up my cavalry. Blap, 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 blap. Yeah, it's annoying. It's annoying. If only I had some more cavalry. If only I could recruit every Khand unit. Oh, that'd be... that'd be easy mode, man. That would be easy mode. Khand was pretty much easy mode by the end of it, because we had the we had a stable increase of Orokani dwarves. And we, of course, had tons and tons of cavalry. Let's always make sure you fire at the front unit, because he tends to overshoot with his grape shot. So you're always going to get some backsplash and kill those laddies. Alright, he's moving his troops now. Let's see, can we get one more volley off? Should be able to, right? ...18% already down. See that? Boom, 24, but that was 6% in one shot. 6% in one- you know how insane that is? Man. Yeah, if you're playing as a dwarves, you need to use dwarven catapults. They are so... so strong. In my opinion, they might even be a bit OP. They might be into, veer into broken territory in how strong they are. Fire away! You can still get one shot off before they probably kick you off the catapult. Okay, not sure what they're trying to do. They're running because of three fucking Grimborn Reavers running after them. Can't blame them. Alright, 3% for 40%. I like those odds. Alright, Mr. Grinfarn. I don't want to friendly fire you. Make sure you fire on the runners, because you get a good angle of them. Boom. That unit's decimated before they can even reach us. Oh, I should write a poem about these fucking Grapeshaw catapults, man. They are just lovely. Just lovely. No, actually, do not fire on them. They might hit our own Grimborn Reavers, which we, of course, do not want. Huh, little pussy. Let me show what the general army is, or the general unit is. Probably gonna kill some of my own Grimborn. Ah, so be it. Just abandon the catapults. You have done all you had to do. And I'm very grateful for that. Very grateful? I'll be here all day, folks. Oh, yes. The Izzy Comedy Central. You know you love it. Yeah, I hope they give Grinfarn a special ability. I feel like he's a special general and he deserves to have a special ability, you know? Something unique. Doesn't have to be OP, doesn't have to make him stronger than he already is. I mean, every ability, I guess, does make the unit a bit stronger, but doesn't have to be anything crazy. Just something that makes him stand out more. Because right now he's a bit of a bland general. Sure, he has a custom bodyguard unit, but he also doesn't have a custom model, for example. It just looks the same. Alright, who's still standing? Apparently 27% still standing. Okay, so they're pushing through there, so let's get our Grimborn in. Grimborn Reavers, Grimborn Reavers. Ballista's technically still alive as well, but not for long. The battle is very much in our favor. Oh, most of our losses anyway. Oh crap. Let's continue, because we do have cavalry. We can actually run them down. That's the nice thing about this army. I can actually slaughter my enemies. So someone pointed out in a previous video that it's not 90% that's the threshold, but it's actually 85. But I will always go over a bit, just to be on the safe side of things, but yeah, I always thought it was 90 for some reason. Not sure where I pulled that number from. But it's of course important to make sure that if you crush this army, they're gone, and they don't just run off with the survivors. If you kill, of course, that magic number, then they're all gone, no matter how many survive. If it's 15%, 10%, they're all gone. No matter if it's like a full unit that's like still completely healthy. Pretty good. So in total we lost 6%. 259, 313. Oh my god. Yeah, man. You cannot play this campaign without Dwarven Catapults. I mean, you can, but you shouldn't. They're so good. You should never, ever, ever not use them. If I could train it, I would have, like, 3 catapults in every army, standard. Just, yeah. Just kill him. Alright. Execute, you're out of here. Yup, sack your camp. Should probably train some new units. We could send over some units we've already trained, but we're keeping the... My god. Don't tell me that Divide and Conquer does not do banner spam. What the hell is this? This is banner spam like crazy, man. Probably has more units than I do. There's no way he can afford any of it, but... hey, I don't care. Alright, I should probably start recruiting earlier to just empty out the pools, but it seems most pools are still depleted. Move you all to Tharbad. Tharbad's where the party's at. Oh, catapult. Nice. And for Hamgathol. Nice! Alright, pretty good. We will have some elites coming in soon. I think Matraith can also start trading some good units. I can get catapults. That's all I need. Yeah, get more catapults. Definitely get more and more troops. Build some great roads. Sudur can get catapults as well. Nice! More catapults! Catapults are key! Oh, we have an extra general here. Let's already send him over. We don't let him wait for nothing. Alright, Captain Hanna. We got Faye Gimli coming in as well. Wait, it's two ballistae? It's fairly cute. I don't want to waste all my money though, because yeah, we are losing tons of money. So that will be it for episode 27. But we didn't achieve quite as much as I would have liked. But we are pushing more and more into that territory. More and more armies are coming in, of course. There's still a lot to take care of. So I will try to take down Gazmog, Bolsmog, and then use either one of these forces to take... well, actually, I use both forces. One to take Bregnus and one to take... what's it called? Durwath. And then we can kind of make a pincer maneuver on towards Isenrun and Isengard. This bridge is going to be crucial. Actually, just taking Fulberg would be quite useful. You know what? Let's actually toggle the Fog of War. Fuck it. We have the Palantir, of course, in Undertowers. Let's take a look at what's going on. Alright, so Khazad-Dûm is holding out for now, but it seems like they might lose Khazad-Dûm West. So I'm not sure what they're doing over here. I mean, they took Birig, which is it's good. Do I have military access? No, I should give them military access, because then they can help out. I mean, they don't really care too much about not having military access, but I should give them that, so they'll be more inclined to attack Isengard on other fronts. But yeah, as you can tell, it's going to be a fucking slog fest against Isengard. Take a look at the end of turn report. Population-wise, we are number 3. Production, we are number 1. Financially, we are number 2, but yeah. You can't compare it against the Dwarves of Khazad-Dûm, of course. Military-wise, we're number 5, which... I don't think that's wholly accurate. I would say, military-wise, we're number 3 or 2. Mordor will definitely be first. Isengard, either second or us second. I don't see which other factions would still be ahead of us. Like, Rhun something? Nah. That doesn't seem correct entirely. But yeah, we do have 39 regions, which is a lot more than the ones we need to hold. But we need to hold Khazad-Dûm West and Mount Gundabad. So, you know, if I really want... oh, actually, it's Mordor that holds Edoras. I thought it was Isengard. I always feel like Isengard and Mordor are at war because it seems like the territory shifts, but I guess it doesn't. So Isengard actually doesn't have that much territory in Rohan. They actually have most of their territory in Gondor. Yeah, the road to Isengard. Saruman isn't even here. Where is Saruman? Is he still alive? Can we spot him anywhere? Yeah, I know he has a custom model. Yeah, I don't know where he is. But I feel like the war with Isengard is actually not that bad. I mean, they're sending in more and more forces, and it's tons of banner spam that I'm not sure if I want to see through all the way to the end. But we are pushing towards Isengard. We're taking more and more territory, and yeah, once we take some certain key locations, I should not forget about Gind, then it is looking rather healthy. Now Sauron will return soon, of course, so we'd have that to worry about. Maybe I can teleport some forces around so we can end the campaign with like a Mordor versus... oh my god, Erebor holds Karazgaladon. What an interesting turn of events. That's... I've never, ever seen that happen. But yeah, Erebor's doing pretty well. They are keeping Isengard a little bit busy, but not as much as I would like. And yeah, main deal's just withering away. Mordor is doing some bloody banner spam if I've ever seen any. Holy cow. It's crazy shit going on here. Zogluk. Yeah, I don't know where Saruman is. No idea. Anyway, this was episode 27 of our Ered Luin campaign. I hope you guys enjoyed the episode, and I do hope to catch you next time. Stay safe and stay inside. Bye-bye.